There's something of cursed meat when it comes to games like this. How do you describe Cartel? How do you describe a Powered by the Apocalypse game written by Magpie Game CEO Mark Diaz Truman about the fucking cartel? Not just some indistinct lesser cartel either. Oh no, it's about the fucking Sinaloa Cartel. You know, the second largest cartel in Mexico, the most active drug cartel in the northern fucking hemisphere. You know, the same one that starting in January 5th, 2023 led to a large-scale series of unrest, which led to 10 Mexican soldiers, one police officer being killed, as well as a little over 50 wounded. That one. But oh no, Cartel isn't about the Mexican drug war, it's about the characters in the middle of it, and the situations they find themselves in. That's why you have drug moves. Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself here. Cartel is a Powered by the Apocalypse game, but let's not kid ourselves here, you already know what the hell that is, and this basic infographic will help you understand if you don't. But what does Cartel bring to the table outside the Sinaloa Cartel's $3 billion United States dollars annual revenue? No, bad Notepad. Cartel brings jack shit, really. The first part of the book is mostly about the history of Mexico and the cartel. Stats are broken down to face, grit, hustle, and savagery. Well, and technically heat. The first four are your standard ones, but heat is unique as it represents how in your particular character is. For example, the Jose Miguel Rosas playbook has a heat of zero, meaning he's effectively safe, compared to the Gustavo Cortez playbook, which has a heat of +2. These are only used for heat moves, which there are a grand total of 3 of them. None of the playbooks are actually too exciting, from Walter Blanco, evil fucking cop Mike from Breaking Bad, adding in Sal Bueno in future expansions. That will come out, right? Mark Diaz Truman, CEO of Magpie Games, right? Now, this game follows a more Baroque approach to the PBTA format, classical but slightly different. This is mostly through the inclusion of keys, which act as your one way to consistently get XP through generally being a terrible human being, but you'll want some actual XP because you don't really choose your starting stat line either. All of this held together with a betting resource being stress. Stress handles everything from breaking your lay to breaking bad. Most of the time, you're going to be gambling with gaining or losing stress for your primary way of survival. When you're at zero, you're in pretty fucking vulnerable state, similar to how there were 3 who were arrested in Fort Worth the other day for trying to sell 125,000 fentanyl pills for the cartel, but I digress. But how do you clear that stress? You have 4 options. Call someone a bitch, confess your sins to a priest, but you'll be forced to lie to them, or beat the fuck out of someone. Alternatively, you can just do drugs, such as cocaine, heroin, crystal fucking meth, or just drink some booze, all of which have a dedicated move tied to them. Finally, how do you die? Well, you do that by getting fucking shot. Well, no, seriously, that's the name of the move, get fucking shot. While it is evocative, forcing cartel members to effectively gamble with getting fucking shot, it wasn't really actually created by Magpie Games CEO Mark Diaz Truman, instead Jason Morningstar of Bully Pulpit Games. The entire game is tainted meat, the worst kind of tainted meat, the type that both takes itself far too seriously and yet distances itself from what it's actually saying. The type of game that will, with absolutely no irony, say, if the Sinaloa Cartel is classic rock, perfecting the combination of violence and patronage that made Mexico a narco state in the first place, then Los Zetas is dubstep, while at the same time releasing Cartel Santos candles, fake meth candy, and a cartel gangster rap album effectively with it. But hey, it's fine. He said we're bad people. We're no heroes, right, cabron? My name is Notepad Add-on, and this was Cartel. If you like what I do here, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. And many thanks to the plutocrats as always. Your patronage is always appreciated. Godspeed, good luck, and I'll see you across the border. Special.